AITA for telling my mom the exact moment I lost all love and respect for her? I, 21 am, live with my older sister, 23, and my two younger sisters, 17 and 15. My older sister currently has legal custody over our two younger sisters and at one point even had legal custody over me when I was still a minor. She basically gained custody of us all when she was 19 because our mom was an addict. My mom is currently going through end-stage renal kidney failure, assumingly because all of those years of not taking care of herself caught up to her. When she first started going to dialysis about 5 months ago, she put me down as her emergency contact, and at first I just sucked it up and dealt with it, because she doesn't have anyone else in this part of the country and my older sister don't talk to her for reasons you can imagine. However, yesterday when the clinic contacted me, and I had to pick her up, I informed her that she needed to put someone else down because I wouldn't be answering those calls anymore after she had her family members leave threatening messages to my older sister. This pissed her off, and she started going on about why I didn't love her anymore and when I stopped loving her. So I told her the exact moment I stopped loving her and respecting her was when I was 13. I had just entered high school. I was big into football, and the coach at that time was brutal. He was making us practice 2 times a day, at 5 a.m., and after school. I told her how I woke up one morning and she was passed out on the couch off of whatever substance she was using at the time, and my older sister, only 15 at the time, was freaking out because we had no food. We never had any food. She was freaking out thinking I was going to pass out from all of that practice and barely eating. I tried to assure her that I would be fine, but she went into that kitchen, grabbed the only things we had, which were 2-day-old almost burnt rice, salt, a can of green beans, and half a chicken breast, and made me and our siblings an entire fried rice meal. She made sure I ate that morning, and I ate that meal on my way to practice crying. She had to stay home from school that day like she did most days to send younger sisters off to school and to be there to pick them up. When I got home from that day, my sister was in the kitchen cooking dinner, and there were some groceries in the fridge that she brought with the money that she got from selling her rings that our grandma gave her to some sketchy ass guy that used to hang out at the convenience store, all while she remained high and passed out. I told her that's when all love and respect for her vanished. She cried and told me that I was evil, having a moral conflict because I'm wondering if I should have been softer with her. AITA? Info. My dad passed away of an OD when I was 8. So he was really no better than my mom. NTA. You aren't evil. Your mother's neglect was. I wouldn't be answering those calls anymore after she had her family members leave threatening messages to my older sister. Time to go, no contact with your mother and these family members. Good luck. NTA and the fact that she heard that heartbreaking story and is still playing the victim tells me all I need to know about her. Honestly, you were nicer than I would have been. NTA. Call the clinic yourself and say and let them know you will not be responsible for her. She didn't take care of you when you were young and vulnerable. She doesn't deserve that care now that the roles are reversed. Not all parents deserve to be parents. Your mom is just upset you give her an actual specific answer, which says to me, when you say you don't love or respect her, you mean it. Info. Where was your dad in all this? Was he in the picture at all? NTA. Former addict. Here. So NTA. Op. Your mother absolutely failed you. And she continues to fail you by calling you evil, instead of reflecting and trying to be better for her kids. Your mother is not a victim, she's an addict. We addicts have to work daily to be the people we're supposed to be, not the one our drug made us into. Your mother would do well to remember that. Someone on Reddit recommended the book Adult Children of Emotionally Immature Parents, and it helped me. Try it. You have a lot of resentment. Write a letter to your mom and your dad. Where was he? With all your feelings in it, and then burn it for catharsis. As you watch the flames, focus on letting go of the hurt and resentment. NTA. It sounds like she deserved the loss of love and respect and never bothered to earn it back. That is a rough life to live, and her playing the victim is asinine. She sounds like a narcissist. NTA. Your mom was trying to emotionally manipulate you. You shared some truth. Nothing wrong with that, you did. NTA. She neglected you and is actively emotionally abusive. You deserved to speak the truth, and she deserved to hear it. NTA. Your sister is a saint. NTA. Not evil. Just correcting her, since she out the subject out there. Sorry you had to grow up so quickly. You have a great sister. Woof. Hard NTA. Not really sure what else to say. But that's all on her and her choices. Not you or any of your siblings. NTA. This woman gave birth to you and your siblings, but is not your mom. Addiction is a disease, but it does not excuse neglect. If she couldn't kick the habit, she should have found alternative caregivers. She made her choices, and now she can't make demand. NTA. She put you down as her emergency contact in an attempt to manipulate you and to make herself look like a good mother to the staff at the dialysis clinic. She has her flying monkeys, which means she has plenty of other people to fill that role. You stood up for the person who has always stood up for you, and that's an automatic NTA. If your mother didn't want to be thought of as a bad mother, then she should have stepped up and done the job instead of forcing your badass older sister into the role. NTA. Her situation is unfortunate, but she neglected her children when they needed her. She started going on about why I didn't love her anymore and when I stopped loving her. You confirmed it. Nothing more. Nothing less. NTA. You're not responsible for her. You don't owe her anything. Your reasons for not wanting to be contacted about her care are valid. I hope you and your sister are safe from the threatening messages. NTA. How threatening are those messages? You may want to save them in case the police get involved. NTA. Abusers and users know how to manipulate, make you doubt yourself. You're fine. NTA. The truth, accurately described, can't be evil. It just is. You saying it, especially when she asked, is also not evil. I hope you and your siblings are doing better and can get some closure before or after your mother kicks off. NTA. Absolutely not. You take care of yourself and your sisters. Y'all are a family. Your mother lost any right to claim the poor me card a long time ago. Karma's a bitch, and your mom is finding it out.
If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlists full of similar content. Epic Aracast is like doom scrolling for your ears. Please like, share, and subscribe.